Witchcraft. The first detailed study of witchcraft was made by Evans Pritchard in 1926-30 among the Azande of the Sudan-Congo border. The notion widely prevalent in Africa that witchcraft is actual substance present in some people's body who are simple, ordinary persons who are born with a substance for witchcraft in their bodies. This list is an illustration of the widespread tendency on the part of some groups to explain many of the ordinary as well as extraordinary occurrences of life by reference to witchcraft. The Azande and neighboring tribes distinguish between witchcraft or an inborn and often unconscious capacity to work evil and sorcery or deliberate actions undertaken for the purpose of doing specific harm. Some anthropologists attempted to generalize this distinction, but in many societies there is no division between two types of evildoers. Perhaps a more practical classification is Lucy Mayer's distinction between nightmare witches and everyday witches. The nightmare witch is the very embodiment of a society conception of evil, a being that flouts the rules of sexual behavior and disregards every other standard of decency. Nightmare witches being almost literally the product of dreams and repressed fantasies have much in common wherever they appear. Both the modern Navajo and ancient Roman, for example, conceive of witches that can turn themselves into animals and gather to feast on corpses. Everyday witches are real people, often the social deviants of a group, those who are morose, who eat alone, who are arrogant and unfriendly. Such witches may be dangerous when offended and retaliate by causing sickness, death, crop failure, cattle disease, or any number of lesser ills. People thought to be witches are usually treated very courteously. Witchcraft includes broadly any claim of possessing the ability to produce effects by compact with a supernatural power. In Europe, witchcraft cults may go back to fertility cults indigenous since Paleolithic times, the chief festivals being Candlemas, May Eve, Lammas, and November Eve. The few surviving direct accounts of rituals show that a horned god symbolizing the fertility of cattle, sheep, goats, or occasionally deer was venerated, and that the local leader of the cult impersonated and was regarded as the incarnation of this god. This explains Christian traditions of the devil with horns and tails. Such ceremonies are depicted in the Paleolithic cave murals of Altamira, Ariège, etc. The object of seasonal rites was probably to promote fertility by sympathetic magic. In time, the original cult received discarded beliefs from other cults which tended to obscure its origins. The function of witchcraft. As Mayer aptly observed, Witchcraft, New York, McGraw-Hill, 1969, page 37, is a world where there are few proven techniques for dealing with everyday crisis, especially sickness, a belief in which is not foolish. It is indispensable. No one wants to resign oneself to illness, and if the malady is caused by a witch's hex, the magical encounter measure should cure it. Not only does the idea of personalized evil answer the problem of unmerited suffering, it also provides an explanation for which no cause can be discovered. Witchcraft provides the explanation, and in so doing also provides both the basis and means for taking counteraction. The psychological functions of witchcraft among Navajo, according to Clyde Kluckhorn, Navajo witchcraft served to channel anxieties, tensions, frustrations that were caused by the pressures from the white man. The rigid rules of decorum among the Navajo allow little means of expression of hostility, which is released in witchcraft accusations, which funnel pent up negative emotions against individuals. They permit the direct expression of hostile feelings against people to whom one would ordinarily be unable to express anger or enmity. Social functions of witchcraft among Ndembu. According to Victor W. Turner, it shows how an accusation of sorcery was used to justify a political process and to effectively reaffirm such norms as the relationship between generations and the method of succession to operate. Thank you.